In this video, we'll use 3D animation to show you the inside of the Space Needle, which is in Seattle, Washington. We'll also talk about how the tower was built and what to expect on your next visit. Here's the United States. On the west coast is Washington State. The city of Seattle is right here, kind of in between all of this water. The Space Needle is right here. It was originally built for the World's Fair in 1962. It took 13 months to build. The first thing they did was dig a big hole to put the foundation. We want the tower to be as stable as possible. They poured 5,600 tons of concrete. This meant that when the tower was finished, the center of gravity would be underground. Now it's time to start building the structure. Construction finished just in time for the opening of the World's Fair. You have to remember that the 1960s was the space race, which eventually led to the first astronauts landing on the moon. The general public had their sights on the future and on space travel. This is why the top of the Space Needle is made to look like a flying saucer. But when you're up at the top, it's designed to make you feel like you are in the clouds floating above the city. While you're at the top, you can get a good view of the harbor, surrounding landscape, and of course, downtown Seattle. There's even a monorail that will take you there. The base of the tower has had a few renovations since it was first opened. Now there's a bit more to see and do while you're at the bottom. Don't forget to admire the massive size of the tower when you're at the bottom. On your trip to Seattle, make sure you visit other buildings right around the tower. The Space Needle is usually compared with the Eiffel Tower in Paris, France. Both are icons for the cities they are in. Up at the top, we have two viewing floors, three elevators, the skyline level, and the base of the tower. As a tourist, you'll want to approach from the north side. Walk up these steps, and then you can buy your tickets here. They also have kiosk machines that are pretty easy to use. Back in 1962, tickets only cost a dollar, but today you'll have to pay a bit more than that. After getting your tickets, you can begin your way up the circular ramp. In times past, you may have had to wait in a long line, but now the Space Needle has timed tickets, so that when you arrive at your designated time, the line will hopefully be a lot shorter. Once you get inside here, they have displays along the wall to learn more about the Space Needle. Then we just keep on heading up the circular ramp until we go all the way around. Notice how we're right above where we bought our tickets. Down below, you'll be able to get a good view of the gift shop. We'll visit this at the end of the tour. When it's your turn, enter the elevator and begin the climb. Each elevator can fit about 25 people. It will take about 41 seconds to get to the top. We'll get out on the very top floor, which is the observation deck. This level lets you go outside and view the surrounding area in any direction. The glass panels are tilted outwards, and actually the benches are tilted out as well, which can be a little scary at first. Before the renovation in 2017, the observation deck looked like this. The guardrail was higher, and it was completely closed in by wires. I like the new look with the glass panels because it feels a lot more open. On the inside are tables and chairs when you're ready for a break. When you want to go down below, you can head down these curved stairs. This is the service level. There's not much to do here, but there are restrooms if you need it. The lower deck is called the Loop. It features the world's only revolving glass floor. I hope you're not afraid of heights. It will rotate all the way around in about 30 minutes. Now, the center of this floor doesn't rotate. It's only the outer edges that rotate. This means there's a line in the floor that shows this separation. What's neat is that you can actually see some of the gears at work along the edge here. You can also view the structure of the building and watch as the elevators go up and down. Just remember that only the floor is spinning, so if you put any belongings down on the side here, you will slowly spin away from them. Over the years, the Space Needle has featured 3 separate restaurants on the bottom deck. Currently, there's no restaurant here, but there may be food options again in the near future. When you're ready to come back down, you can wait in line for the elevator here. The center of the Space Needle has mostly supports for the elevators. On busy days, all 3 elevators will be in use with passengers. On the inside, you'll find the stairs, mostly for emergency purposes. From time to time, it's been opened up for athletic competitions and charitable events. Personally, I'd rather take the elevator. At the bottom, the elevator will take you to the gift shop that you saw earlier on your way up the curved ramp. For private events like weddings or company meetings, you'll need to rent out the skyline level, which is only 100 feet off the ground. Even though it's not as high up, it still offers some amazing views. The Space Needle was renovated in 2017, so even if you've been there recently, make sure to go see it again the next time you're in Seattle. For watching this video about the Space Needle, my name's Jared. I'll see you next time.